Dear students, let us start the discussion on today's newspaper, that is 10th October 2017. Yesterday I was in Delhi and my internet connection was not working to upload the video for you. So the yesterday's video will be uploaded to you by today evening. So the first is, Gujarat High Court commutes death term of 11 Godhra convicts. The word of focus here is commuting. Commuting means changing the quality of punishment. Here the punishment from death sentence is changed to life imprisonment. Supreme Court bans sale of crackers in Delhi. So it is to have a pollution free and also firecracker free Deepavali. And then Nobel for Economics. The Nobel for Economics went to the professor at University of Chicago, Mr. Richard Thaler. His major work is also recognized or regarded as father of behavioral economics. His major contribution is to the behavioral economics. So the major issues he worked on are limited rationality, social preferences, lack of self-control. So lack of self-control, it means many a times why people give importance to short-term things rather than to the long-term benefits. That is what is based on the behavioral economics. Second aspect is social preferences. Many a times prices are not increased in proportion to the demand, but it is increased whenever the cost of production goes high irrespective of the demand. That is also a kind of irrational behavior. So like this, he has worked on behavioral economics and laid foundation for the same, which he got the Nobel. And there are also few other news which I don't have the slides. One is the Parsi woman and their religious conditionalities after marriage. She took it to the constitutional bench. As per the Parsi religion, a woman, if she marries outside the religion, then she loses all religious rights. She can't even attend the funeral of her parents because only Parsis are allowed to enter into the funeral. And second aspect is they cannot enter the holy places like fire temple, etc. So the Parsi woman, they went to the Supreme Court saying that it is violative of their Article 25. According to Article 25, any person can profess, practice and propagate his religion. And a Parsi woman, as they married outside the religion, they are not allowed to this particular right. So the Special Marriages Act, which provides for this, has to be amended or changed. That is what is the demand over here. Now coming to the editorial page, the first article is related to Nepal. Tail wags the dog in Kathmandu. It means, let's understand the political scenario in Nepal. The most important party is Nepali Congress, United Marxist Leninist, and then you have Maoist Party. Our Communist Party of Nepal, Maoist. So these are the three important parties, and you have Madhesis and many small parties. Initially, UML and the Communist Party of Nepal, they together formed the government. And Mr. Oli is the Prime Minister. And finally, it has ended as Communist Party of Nepal, Maoist, moved close to Nepali Congress. So in this, Prachanda has become the Prime Minister, followed by Sher Bahadur Devba of Nepali Congress. Now, a leftist fraction is developing in which UML and Communist Party of Nepal, Maoists, they want to contest the upcoming provincial and parliamentary elections. So, the major takeaways here are the Communist Party of Nepal, Maoists of Prachanda, it did not enjoy the respect or else credibility among the people now. So it has got the credibility after the Janandolan 1 and 2. Slowly, the Prachanda's opportunistic coalitions he formed eroded that. But however, as both Nepali Congress, United Marxist Leninist Communist Party of Nepal, United Marxist Leninist, as they are unable to do that, as they are unable to work in ideological alignment, so either of them are coming together to work with Prachanda. So in this case, He explains this situation as the tail. Tail means Communist Party of Nepal Maoist is wagging the dog. The dog is the Communist Party of Nepal, United Marxist Leninist and Nepali Congress, which have settled the ideological debate in Nepal. To an extent, India's interventionism is also a reason. That's what the author says. Knitting a safety net. So, among the young people below 29 years of age after adolescent, the second most common cause of death is suicide. Why the suicide is increasing? The reasons are economic distress, loss of sense of belongingness, weakening social support systems, lack of social security mechanisms from the state, huge costs, healthcare costs, all these are making mentally ill patients to take the extreme step of suicide. How it has to be handled? Social security systems have to be strengthened and social networks need to be improved in the country. The growing urbanization and all these are alienating the old people, but that has to be improved. And along with that, we also have to find for a way out with regard to the existing system where the healthcare costs are growing up and up. These things have to be changed. That is what knitting a safety net means. Next we have towards transparency. What does this mean? Now, Supreme Court Collegium is the body that appoints the judges to higher judiciary. And the work of the Collegium is highly secretive. Recently, Supreme Court made a decision to keep every detail related to the appointment of the judges, their transfers and promotions, and with valid reasons in the public domain. So this is a very welcome step. Along with this, two more steps if the Supreme Court takes, the transparency in the judiciary goes to the next level. So the Collegium, when it was challenged, or else National Judicial Appointments Commission was challenged, Supreme Court upheld the Collegium system, and at the same time it also stated that it has to be made more transparent. Then Union has prepared the Memorandum of Procedure, and the judiciary did not express its opinion on that. If Memorandum of Procedure is followed, to an extent, a predictability in the appointment of judges will improve. And second aspect with regard to the judiciary is nepotism and all these things shall go away. For this, for screening of the judges, there has to be a secretariat for the Collegium. So once this improved, the appointment process to higher judiciary gets streamlined. Problem animals. The human-animal conflict is growing in India. So in this, the easy solution which the forest officials follow is taking that predator away from its natural forest to the other place. Because of this, the alienation of the predator is increasing. Normally, a predator needs a particular area to hunt. So, if it has been taken to the new area, there will be a competition among the predators. Ultimately, it leads to the fight. And the predator generally goes back to its original space. Or if it is there in the new place, it becomes much aggressive too. So, that's why whenever human-animal conflict is there, the relocation of the predator is not a solution. That is scientifically proven to be wrong. That's what this article talks about. And next, steel frame. So, Indian bureaucracy, Indian civil services, it is described as the steel frame of India. Now, Fulton Committee in UK has reformed the civil services there towards the specialization. In India, still we consider civil services to be a domain of generalist. And civil services is more seniority-based promotions rather than merit-based promotions. So to improve the quality of civil services, what this author says is, the seniority shall be replaced by merit in India in promotions, and also we have to create domain expertise. It means we have to divide all the subjects which the government is dealing with certain clusters, and an officer who is posted to his cluster, he shall be moved among this. Let's take finance cluster. Ministry of Finance, Industries, commerce, all this, if they come under the cluster, an officer shall continue his career only in that cluster so that he becomes specialized in that area. That's what the author talks about. Now, it is at Bond, stay the course. It is about climate change. So, the Paris conference was said to be the remarkable, and there, INDCs are promised by the countries. INDC stands for Intended Nationally Determined Commitments. Now, the target at the Paris is 1.5 degrees C. So, it is supposed to be a tough target. And as the INDCs of all the countries are added up, it goes greater than 2 degrees C. So, that's why it is unrealistic target that is the first challenge. And most of the INDCs are conditional. It means they have to get the technical and financial support from the developing countries. Third, USA under Trump has already declared that it is moving out of the Paris conference, Paris agreement. It means to what extent other countries will be committed to this is a major question. So, there are many challenges before the climate change negotiations. Staying on the course is essential. That is the article's emphasis is. Now, coming to the next page, fix or nix the Iran nuclear deal. So, it is an ultimatum given to the President Trump from Israel. Either change the nuclear deal to make it much tighter or do away with the deal altogether. So, United States, if President do not recertify the Iran nuclear deal, it is expected that US credibility in international diplomacy will come down and the West Asia as a region will go through much instability. Now, in the last page, I gave you the notes which will be available to you at lax.in/civilsprep. Thank you very much and all the best. By evening, I'll give you the yesterday's video to you. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.